Hello friends, now we are going to discuss about the corrosion control by cathodic protection. The protection of metal from the corrosion by making them completely cathodic and no sight of the metallic object is allowed to act as anode. We know that if the metal is behaving as anode, then it can easily undergo corrosion. Here, we are going to make that metal as a completely cathode, so that it will be prevented by the corrosion. If there is no part of anode, then there is no corrosion take place in the corrosive medium. The cathodic protection is done by the two methods, that is sacrificial anodic protection, other one is impressed current method. First, we are going to discuss about the sacrificial anodic method. In the sacrificial anodic method, the metal structure to be protected is made relatively cathode by using anodic metal contact with it, so that the corrosion is now concentrated on more on anodic metal, protecting the base metal from the corrosion. The sacrificial anode to be replaced by fresh ones as it is used continuously whenever it is required. Commonly used sacrificial anodes are magnesium, zinc and aluminium. Here, the more active metal is connected to the base metal through copper wire, insulated copper here. Consider a iron pipe present in the inside the moisture containing soil. If the moisture containing will be there, this iron generally will undergo corrosion. In order to prevent this corrosion of this iron pipe by the sacrificial method, we have to use the one metal which is more active than the iron. So here we are going to use the magnesium metal bar. This magnesium metal bar is connected to the iron pipe through the copper wire, insulated copper wire. That time it will looks like a differential metal corrosion, where two different metals are in contact with each other and they are jointly exposed to the corrosive environment, so that here the metal which is having the lower reduction potential, that is more active metal, will undergo corrosion because it is acting as a anode, and this base metal will act as a cathode. So that here iron pipe is acting as a cathode and a magnesium bar is acting as a anode, because magnesium is more active than the iron and both are connected. Because of this, here there is no side of anodic part on the iron. This iron pipe completely converted into cathode. Hence, it is prevented from the corrosion. But instead of this iron pipe, magnesium is undergoing the corrosion. Here, by using the one of the most active metal, we are going to prevent the corrosion of base metal. The advantage of this sacrificial anodic method is, the method is very simple and economical. No power supply required for this metal, because here active metal itself undergoing oxidation, hence it is going to produce a corrosive current. Because of that, base metal will act as a cathode and it will require minimum maintenance. Disadvantage of this metal process is, we are going to lose the more active metal, so that we have to replace the time by time the active metal with new one. The application of this sacrificial anodic method is used for the oil tank, ship cells and underground cable, which is going to prevent the corrosion. Next method in the cathodic protection, we are going to discuss that impressed current technique. In this method, the anodic base metal, which is oxidizable, in which corrosion reaction is supplied with electrons. The current is applied in the opposite direction to nullify that corrosion current. That is through the small current flow means of battery, so that oxidation is suppressed and corrosion of base metal is reduced. And the insoluble anode is used here in the soil and connected to the structure to be protected from the corrosion. The anode is usually placed in a backfill to provide a better electrical contact with surrounding. This employed to the larger metal structure buried in soil. Here, iron steel pipe inside the soil, which is moisture containing, and it will undergo corrosion very easily. Here, when the iron will undergo corrosion, it will undergo oxidation and it will produce the electron. Those electrons will reach the cathode. That we are going to call it as corrosion current. By using battery, we are going to apply the sufficient amount of current which can suppress, nullify this corrosion current, so that it will act as a cathode. And the negative terminal of the battery is connected to a more stable anode, so that here graphite is used as a anode here and steel pipe will become cathode. Here, by passing the certain amount of current, we are going to nullify the corrosion current, so that this metal will act as a cathode and it will prevent it from the corrosion. Application of this impressive current method is, it is used for the oil tanks. If the oil tank present inside the soil, here it is connected to the positive impressed current corrosion current method. Here impressed current cathodic protection is done. Here the tank is made as cathode by connecting into the positive terminal, and this graphite anodes are made as anode. Here we are going to apply the sufficient amount of current so that it will nullify the corrosion current, so that this entire tank will become cathode and it is prevented from the corrosion. In the ship hull is continuously in contact with salt water, so that it can easily undergo corrosion. This ship hull is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and another graphite anode is used. When current is passed, it will nullify the corrosion current which is produced by the oxidation of this ship hull, so that this ship hull will become as a cathode and it is prevented from the corrosion. This is how we are going to prevent the corrosion by cathodic protection, where we are going to make that entire metal surface into a cathode. In the electrochemical theory, we have discussed that the metal which is acting as a cathode, which will be prevented from the corrosion. That's why here that metal entirely is converted into the cathode. By making it cathode, we are going to prevent the corrosion.